Tabletop Review SIG P226 Long Rifle, or LR. That was three on that plate, I think, right? Nice, smooth, mag change. Get your breath under control. 2 points apiece on this plate. Hit. 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 Nice, hit. 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 Nice. Time wrong. Are you going for the 118-yard one? Dude, if you connect, I'll be very impressed. Did you just hit it?
You hit the base, dude.
Nice. Good job, dude. There are lots of outstanding designs out there, but dudes, I'll tell you, nothing much has changed. You are still looking at one of my most favorite and trusted go-to-war pistol options, the Sig Sauer P226. And when I say go-to-war pistol, what am I talking about? Guys that follow TMP know exactly, but I'll just review it real quick. In terms of size, weight, firepower, accuracy, ergonomics, field strip, maintenance, accessories availability, value, durability, and reliability, the pistol just gets it right to a degree that you can bet your life on it, and it will come through for you on that dark and scary night when you actually might have to use that gun to defend your life. It is a go-to-war option. Also, when I mention full-size go-to-war option, this is something that I would strap in my LBE, my load-bearing equipment, whether that's a tactical vest, as you've seen many times in the Nut and Fancy project. Maybe it's a drop-down holster or a holster just hanging by your side. It is a secondary weapon. In most POUs and some POUs, it might be your primary weapon. Just depends on what you have going that day. But the P226 and all of its brethren too, the P228, the 229, and the 220, outstanding in role. And that has not changed. And over many years, it hasn't changed. They are still very solid designs that will serve you well, and you can bet your life on them. This one's in 40 Smith. Choose your caliber. Doesn't matter. 9mm, 357 SIG, also available in the 226. If you want a 45, go with the P220. Lots of variations and varieties out there, and they are all outstanding. I will say this, though. If you're going to get good at shooting your P226 or whatever other P series you have, sorry, I got to get a drink, you're going to go freaking broke. You know that. It's expensive out there, man. To buy the ammo and shoot it and train effectively with this gun is going to cost you a lot of money, and most guys just don't do it. I will say this too, a lot of departments aren't doing it as much as they used to. I'm talking LE guys here, law enforcement, sheriff departments, you know, local PDs have cut their training a lot because ammunition is expensive. And is that trend going to get better? I don't think so. I think it's going to get worse. And that brings us to the subject of this tabletop review, the outstanding training tool and companion to the full-size P226, and that is the P226 Long Rifle. You have seen it in the project for many months now, haven't you? In lots of running guns, we've been getting out there putting lots of rounds through this wonderful training companion to the 226. And I come away very impressed with the gun. It has a lot to offer in all the categories I just mentioned. And I'm going to go down the talking points in this tabletop review as best I can, covering the things not for the regular P226. I've already done that in a series of videos posted last year, which still stand. Nothing changes about that. But we're going to talk about the 22 long rifle version in this one. For brevity, I'm going to call this the P226LR. I think, again, Sig calls it the P226 Classic 22 or something like that. Kind of a longer name. I'm just going to abbreviate it to that. Because that's what it is, 226 and 22 long rifle. And it's not made just for the 226. Varieties for the P220 and the 229 are out there. I think my comments will play for those just as well. That brings us to POU. Primarily a training tool. No surprises there. It is a gun that's going to allow you to get that trigger time on your P-Series SIG to become a better pistol shooter. And that is always a quest, isn't it? It's hard to shoot pistols accurately, especially when your heart rate's really going or you're under stress. This gun will allow you to practice that a lot more. Again, if you're going to do it with center fire, good luck. But the basics of trigger control, breathing, grip, sight alignment, all can be practiced very affordably, at least much more affordably, with the P226LR. And I think a lot of dudes will really dig that capability. I'm going to jump ahead also in accessories and say you can get to this P226LR version in several ways. First off, you can actually go out and buy a 22 chambered P226. And I think that's what this gun was. It came with a 22 slide on it. And of course, and as Sig tells us, you can retrofit it with what they call a center fire exchange kit if you desire. And that's what this box was, containing a 40 Smith & Wesson slide for the P226 that you can slam on top and taking that 22 slide off, including the barrel, recoil spring, magazine, all the components, and just basically make it a center fire defensive pistol. That's one way to do it. If you already have a SIG, maybe you have one like this, the 40, then you would order the 22 caliber exchange kit and just put the slide on top. So two different ways of getting there. Cost-wise, I don't think it's a lot of difference. No matter which way you go, it's going to be expensive. We're talking about SIG here, and SIG just charges a lot. For a ballpark figure, I think going out and buying a P226LR is going to cost you around $450, maybe more, maybe around five, depending on your gun store where you get it from. You could always go to GOG, Gallery of Guns, and get a bid from your local FFL and see what you have. Oh, actually, I misspoke. Gallery of Guns doesn't carry SIG. That's because SIG deals directly with their sellers. Sorry, misled you there. So you're going to have to find it somewhere else. That kind of sucks, really, because I love it when Gallery of Guns has a gun. It just makes it a quicker and easier way for you guys to go get it. Okay, so training tool, obviously. Secondarily, for a lot of guys, it might be just a fun gun. I mean, they may not own any SIGs at all, and they just choose it because they like the looks, they like ergonomics, which we'll talk about. Very similar, of course, to the other series, the P-Series. All of that, and it's just a fun, plinking gun that looks cool and maybe has that military style second type of cool for them. Don't know. And there's other options out there, too, if you're just going for fun 22 plinking. Of course, you don't have to go with a P226LR. You could go with, I don't know, a Buckmark, you know, a Ruger Mark III, 2245. Lots of great options out there, and they're excellent. The downsides to these, when we get back to the first point I made in POU, is they are not the best training tool for you to learn muscle memory, trigger control, and the operation of your SIG series pistols, obviously. Trigger time is trigger time, but if we can get it in a form factor that is very close, or actually in this case, identical to our go-to-war gun, I mean, that's outstanding. And the SIG has it in spades. We'll talk about that as we go down the talking points. One thing you'll notice, speaking of talking points going on down, the SIG P226LR is extremely lightweight. That's because, dudes, it's just a blowback 22. You know? Oh, by the way, some guys say, why are you always wearing gloves? Well, sometimes they do, sometimes they don't. In this case, I do, because if I don't, I just put sweat marks all over the gun while I'm handling it. It's just distracting. But the P226 LR is very lightweight. Without the light on it, and again, this is an outstanding TLR3. I'll do a tabletop on that. Weapon light by Streamlight. Without that light on it, 25 ounces. So very light. Again, that's because of the aluminum slide, because it's nothing more than a blowback slide that mimics the appearance and looks of a full size, like you see in the background, P226. But that makes it very easy to shoot and fun.
Even though
it looks kind of heavy, upon handling the 226 LR, you're going to find that it's very fast in hand, inheriting
that's
all those wonderful ergonomics from the regular 226. Great.
And that's cheap ammo, isn't it?
Really no surprises on size, and not much to talk about there, because it is a carbon copy of its regular centerfire counterpart. Firepower, this might be a quick review. 10 rounds. Very standard in terms of 22 long rifle pistols. You see that in the Buckmark and the Rugers. You saw it in the Kimber slide conversion for the 1911. I did a separate tabletop on that, and they annotate it. Another great option if you're a 1911 aficionado. But these are 10 round max. I kind of wish they did 12, like the Smith 22s, specifically the 422s used to do. But for whatever reason, it's just become the standard 10 rounds. Deal with it. Another great positive thing, jumping ahead in ergonomics, is notice the magazine. It is the same form factor. This is a extended MechGar 40 mag. That's why it has the extended base plate on it. But it has essentially the same form factor as a centerfire mag. That means it's going to fit in your mag pouches. That means your muscle memory is going to be the same as you train with a gun. Another big positive, perhaps over the Buckmarks and the Rugers, maybe the Smith & Wesson options out there, something to consider. So 10 rounds isn't a tremendous amount, of course, but for the primary POU of the 226 LR, that is a training tool. It's almost ideal, I guess, because you're going to run out of ammo quicker, allowing you to practice that most problematic aspect of pistol shooting, at least for a lot of dudes, the reload. And that's exactly what we do in the Nut and Fancy Project. As you've seen in our running guns, we like getting the heart rate up, practicing that reload with consistency, you know, getting our muscle memory trained, so to speak, but you got to do it over and over again. I guess if you had a 20 round magazine, that would just be less opportunity, opportunity for you to do so. So firepower, 10 rounds, sufficient. How's the accuracy on this gun? I would say excellent. While I didn't really bench rest it, most of my shooting, of course, was from standing positions. Actually, I think all of it was from standing positions. In the run and gun scenarios that you saw, and also taking it to an indoor range and shooting it for headshots and also center of mass from standing positions, just to see what the gun could do when, you know, you're taking your time, the heart rate's down, I come away very impressed. One whole groups easily at 7-8 yards. At 15 yards, opens up a little bit. I would say about an inch. Again, I didn't bench rest it at 25 yards. I guess I should have. But I would say the gun's capable in the hands of a really good pistol shooter from the bench. Probably about a 2-inch group at 25 yards, just extrapolating from what I've seen of my own results. But very accurate. On par, actually, with a lot of its competitors, even the Buckmarks, maybe the Rugers as well. I think if you really were taking your time and, you know, it's a bench rest accuracy contest, these guns would probably win. But for most of us who maybe aren't that great of shooters, or we're doing it recreationally or out of a run and gun scenario, you will be very impressed with the accuracy of the 226 LR. My son, Tactical Doodle, had some amazing hits from the gun at 100 yards. You saw it on camera. No kidding. From 100 yards.
Oh,
dinging an Evil Roy steel plate with a SIG P226 LR. And that's fun.
And that's
have a couple videos out there as well showing that at 100 yards you can actually engage quite accurately with most of your pistols. It just takes a little bit of practice. Yeah, it's a lot tougher. I mean, you know, trigger, breath, sight alignment, all that becomes ultra critical at that range. But it's doable and it sure is fun practicing. Great accuracy on the gun, though. I don't think you'll be disappointed at all. I don't see any problems with it at all. Bringing us to ergonomics. First off, let me get a downside out of the way. Even though it is the same exact, well, it's a good thing. It's the same exact form factor of the regular P226. There is one anomaly you need to be made aware of. It does not lock back last round in the 226 SIG conversion. It just doesn't. So what that means, again, of course, safety check. What that means is you're going to end up with this type of situation. Safe direction, safety check. You're just going to dry fire it once at the end of your shot string, as you've seen us do off the running guns. It kind of sucks. I know that. I mean, ideally, we want to train just like the full-size SIG counterpart, like this 40. I would like the slide to do that. Some others do it. I mean, in the inventory and on loan in the Nut and Fancy project, you'll see this too in tabletop, the Advantage Arms by Glock. This is a hard conversion to find, by the way. Great option, and this one does lock back, I understand. Great training tool, and by the way, haven't shot this one yet. I will, though. Get back to you. Be patient. It's coming. So just, you know, it's just something to deal with. It's not going to lock back last round. It's not a showstopper for me because you get so many other things in return, namely the ergonomics of a full-size SIG pistol. If I were to choose my favorite decocking mechanism in the entire world, it is the SIG P226. Like this. It's right where the radius of your thumb already goes. I've said that in other reviews. Perfect. I just love it. You know, you have the slide release easily available right here. Maybe it's just because I have so much time on the SIG design that I like it most, but you know, when we contrast it against similar designs, maybe the FMP9, which I reviewed very positively, I might add, the decocker on the FMP is different, and I just prefer how the SIG does it. Love that. The magazine release, beveled, angled where it should be. The grips are stippled. It's a full-size SIG. All the things I said last year on the series still play. It's just ergonomic. We don't need any inserts on the grip, at least I don't for my hand size, because it's just perfect. You know, it works well. Love it. You know, it's got a little cutout for your grip here, so you can go higher on your grip so your hand is closer to that bore axis for a better recoil recovery. Not that you need it in a a long rifle chambering, but again, we're practicing for this gun in the background, right? That muscle memory consistency is what we're after, isn't it? And that's another benefit. There's your takedown lever, just like a full-size SIG. Has an accessory rail here, which we'll talk about here. How about the sights? They're excellent. Fully adjustable for windage and elevation in the rear. A little bit higher than the regular SIG sights, I think. Maybe about the same. And they're not night sights, they're just regular SIG sights. Some guys say, well, you don't need an adjustable sight. I disagree. On a 22 pistol like this, I really like it because it just depends on what loads I'm shooting. If I'm consistently with my eyeball shooting low left, I want to be able to correct that with some adjustability. Again, this is a training slash recreational tool, so I don't mind if I have adjustable sights on that. The trigger is excellent. Like all SIG triggers, I wouldn't say all, most SIG triggers, lightweight single action. Reasonable double action. Of course it can be improved by a trigger job, no doubt, but out of the box is fine for me. And how about overall feel of the gun? You're not going to be surprised when you hear me say I like it. I love it. The SIG just feels authoritative to me. When you hold it, it feels like it means business. It falls into hand perfectly, has a beautiful balance to it. It's easy to hold on target, especially at a 25 ounce weight of this 226 LR. All these things are just outstanding, inherited from the regular SIG. That's because it is a regular SIG. The only difference between this gun and that gun is the upper, or the slide, the barrel, the recoil spring, and the magazine. Everything else is the same. It's just a regular SIG. And the same can be said if you decide to retrofit your centerfire SIG with a conversion kit. Kind of like we said with the CMMG AR-15 conversion, right? That you get all the benefits of your regular combat gun with a 22 conversion kit. I mean, in terms of AR-15, don't want to get bogged down here, though. You know, grips, you know, aftermarket triggers, all those things. If you've done any of that to your SIG, check it out, man. You get it now in 22 format. Ergonomics are outstanding. Probably forgot some stuff. I'll annotate it if I do. Field strip and maintenance. It's just like a regular SIG. It's easy. I mean, I don't want to spend airtime, but it's just you rotate that lever down, slide comes off, easily disassembling the barrel recoil assembly from the slide, and off you go cleaning. Accessories are just like you see here. compatible with all full-size SIG pistols. Wearing again the TLR-3 because it has an accessory rail. And that gets to another important point with going with a gun like this. That as a training tool, I love a night capability. Maybe you like a laser capability with the way you train with your go-to-war gun. Understood. You kind of miss that when you go with a stock Buckmark or a Ruger. It does not have an accessory rail. Now, of course, you could go with a Tactical Solutions retrofit and perhaps some other options where you would have that Picatinny rail under barrel. Maybe get a Picatinny rail on top if that's what you wanted, and you could have equal capability. But that's more expense. Out of the box, generally doesn't come that way. 226 LR does. So it's easy to slam on a tactical light like the TLR-3 and take it out in the desert, shooting at night, practicing that all-important night shooting skill. And I'll tell you this, dudes, it's completely different than shooting at the day or in the day. Sorry, I had to get a drink. Totally is. If you haven't done it, you need to try it. It is much more difficult to shoot at night. Again, I recommend those Evilroy steel plates as a primary training companion to your .22 pistol, whatever it is. If it's a P226 LR, rock on. Get out there, slam some plates down at your chosen range. I recommend about 15 yards. You see us generally shooting them at about 25, even further, just for fun and more challenge. But it's a great training companion with this, especially at night because you get that instant feedback when you've made a hit. And by the way, that TLR-3, as I'll say in the tabletop, is completely functional out to that range. You know, 25, 30 yards, you'll be able to see it, no problem. But accessories-wise, it will take everything that a regular P-Series SIG pistol will. You know, lights, lasers, sights. I really didn't investigate that too carefully, but it looks to be about, I lied. You can see the dovetails on the back are different. So they won't take regular SIG sights. It's a proprietary 22 long rifle sight. Not a big deal. With a light, by the way, you can still see these at night because your light's going to do the illumination of the target, of course. Okay, no surprise there. If you want, you could put those little glow-in-the-dark dots on there, charge them with your flashlight for training use, you know, only, and you could see them better that way. But the accessories, the versatility of the P226 LR, again, outstanding. Not much bad to say about it. Value. Dudes, I might make this a quick review. I dig it. Value's pretty high, I guess. Again, we're talking SIG here. Nothing's cheap when it has a SIG brand on it. So if I had to be real with it, I guess I'd have to say value kind of sucks compared to some other options. Comparing, you know, keeping in mind, I can go out and buy a Buckmark for $300, maybe less. You know, I've seen stores sell Buckmarks for like $275 on Christmas specials and stuff. You can definitely get those through Gallery of Guns.
Miss.
You know, it just depends. This one, again, around $450. Maybe more, maybe less. That's expensive. So I guess I got to keep it real. The value is not that great. The reason I initially said it's good is because it's so high quality. Remember, when we talk about value, at least when Nuttin' Fancy talks about it, I'm not talking about just cost. I'm talking about quality. And how long is a gun going to last you? If I got a good deal on something and it falls apart under hard use, to me that's not good value. That's poor value. I much rather spend more money and get something quality that I can hand down for generations, like these SIG pistols, and you know, it'll be in the family basically forever. Even though I paid initially more money for it, in terms of long-term value, it still might be pretty high. It just depends who you are, how you classify, you know, your guns, what's important to you. Value's in the eye of the beholder, of course. Overall, though, kind of expensive. And I will say this, too. The magazines, shame on SIG, very expensive. These are like $50 a piece for these polymer magazines, which they have. I didn't like to see that. I would like to see them around, heck, $20 if it was my choice. But, I mean, the PT-1911s, not the PT, but the Kimber 22 mags, they're around $29. So why is this more expensive, SIG? Because it's SIG, and they can. So that's something you need to consider. And if you're going to use it in run-and-gun options, dudes, you're going to need more than one magazine. And the kit comes with just one magazine. Another bad job, SIG. Sorry, got to keep it real. That sucks. It should come with at least two magazines because you need to train with it. Again, we're practicing those reloads, you know, when we exhaust ammunition. Durability and reliability. One reason I waited as long as I did to do this review is because I wanted to get several thousands of rounds through the 226 LRs. And by the way, we've had two in the project testing. You know, guns come and go, they're on loan, they're checked in, they're checked out, it's just hard to keep track. Trust me, I can pretty much get any gun I need to at this point. The problem is time, and especially to give it a thorough shooting review like I did with the 226 LR. Initially, I was not impressed with the reliability, and I will term that a break-in period. I found that the gun would not go into battery after stripping off a fresh round from the magazine, and we actually had to kind of push the rear of the slide to fully seat it, and then we'd fire it and it'd be okay for a little bit, and then again somewhere in the magazine it would still fail to go into battery all the way, you know, kind of like this situation. Okay, and that was with quality ammunition. I was kind of bummed out at first, actually, kind of pissed. I was saying, come on man, this is a SIG, even out of the box it should be 100%. But keep in mind, I've said this before, it's not a center fire gun, it is a 22 long rifle. Anytime we work with 22s, you're going to have spotty reliability at times. The good news is this, as we broke in the SIGs, the 226 LRs, they started firing pretty much with 100% reliability. So I'll term that a break-in period. So now we run whatever ammo we have on hand through them too. Even the garbage Walmart ammo, the Federal, you know, Wildcats, whatever we have, we've ran it through them and we've had pretty good success. When we get tired of the infrequent jam that we have now, and it did jam, I think, a couple times on us, is mostly, though, just a failure to go into battery. But when we get tired of all that nonsense, we just run high-impulse, high-quality ammo, namely CCI Mini-Mag. And that stuff is 100% in these SIG P226 LRs. It's accurate, pretty much 100% reliable. In fact, I can't remember last time I had any issues shooting CCIs in the P226 LRs. Just keep in mind, if you really have issues with any reliability problems at all, you probably shouldn't be shooting 22 long rifle. It's a training tool, recreational tool. Keep that in mind. I think durability will be outstanding. I mean, probably through both of the LRs that we have in inventory, I can't even guess. I know it's well over 2,000 rounds we have through them. Just thousands of rounds and no issues at all. Didn't see any parts flying off, and which actually is to be expected. 22s should be durable. They should last your lifetime. And I've seen as much with my Rugers, you know, the Buck Marks, all the quality 22s. No surprises there. I really not really even a player at all. Let me roll this in about ergonomics, backing up just a bit. Some guys will say, well, should I go with a Mosquito SIG or should I go with a P226 LR, which is more expensive? I would say go with the 226 LR. I like the full size much better. And for almost the same cost, well, let's say it isn't. Let's say it's $100 more, maybe even more. I'm getting all the benefits of the full size SIG. The longer sight radius, it fits my hand better. Again, kind of on the large size for my hand, so it kind of depends on who you're talking about. But these are some considerations. Also, I have found the SIG Mosquitoes to be a little bit more finicky with ammo than this gun. Not bad, and again, if you run the CCI Mini Mags, you'll probably be 100% with it. But if I had to choose, you're looking at my choice right here, 226 LR, mainly for the ergonomics, the training issues, and that's it. So pick your poison, whatever important to you. There's some really cool Mosquitoes out there, especially some awesome colorations, but better training tool right here, dudes. You know it. Durability, reliability, cover that. Track record. Well, all things point up. You know, time will tell, but I don't think we're going to have any bad reports over the years from the P226 LRs or the P220 variations, P229 variations. They are excellent training tools, and they're fun. They're fun. After shooting this so much, I have as much fun with this gun as I do the centerfire. Pretty much. I'll say 98% as much fun. They're just awesome. You got to go out and shoot one to enjoy it. And some guys, you know, will poo-poo the fact that you're going out and training with 22 long rifle. I don't dig those elitist attitudes. I don't. You know, guys act like they have all the money in the world and they can, you know, or all the time in the world to go reload. I think most of us don't. And we actually, if we're going to get trigger time, become better shooters, nowadays, as of 2009, probably going to get worse in the future, 22 long rifles, how to get it done. There you have it. Highly recommended. Very favorable review. P226 LR in the Nut and Fancy Project. We just continue to shoot this gun and have a good time with it. Go out and make some good family and friend memories doing your own running guns, getting out and doing your own adventures. Take lots of pictures. Time is short, and you'll be glad you did, and you become a better pistol shooter as you do it. Thanks, guys. Nothing fancy. See ya.
Standing, SIG P226 long rifle, nothing fancy. I'll take it.
Better than the ladder.
Roger that. I'm gonna check.